On the first problem, I asked what the SAT score was that 2 out of every 3 students who take the test end up scoring below this score. So if 2 out of 3 students are scoring below it, that means 66.6 repeating percent of students score below this SAT test score. So I looked on my Z-score chart, and I needed to figure out the Z-score for 66.6 repeating percent. I came close at 0.6664, and the Z-score is 0.43. So then you work backwards, and if you know the Z-score is 0.43, you can find the individual SAT score that has that Z-score. So I set it up. You'd multiply each side by 300, you would add 1500 to both sides, and the score would be a 1629. So 2 out of every 3 students that take the SAT score less than a 1629 on the test. For the second problem, I said 72% of students will end up with a score of at least what value? And so the part that confuses students on that is 72% score at least what score? So that's communicating that 72% of the students score that score or better. And since our Z-score chart shows the percent of data that's less than a particular Z-score, we have to actually not be looking for 72% on that chart. We're looking for right here, 28%. So I found 28% on the Z-score chart, 0.2810 was as close as I could get, and the Z-score was a negative 0.58. So I figured out the individual SAT score that would have a Z-score of negative 0.58. Multiplied each side by 300, added 1500 to both sides, and got a score of 1326. So 28% of the students score less than a 1326 on the SAT, 72% score at least a 1326. The third problem on the assignment asked for, if I want to talk to 20% of the students who took the SAT, but I want the shortest distance between the two scores, who should I talk to? So the first part of the concept is I can grab 20% of students anywhere on this distribution, but if I grab 20% from the highest score and below, there'd be a big difference between scores because I'd need a lot of range in order to get 20% of the scores. So if I want to keep the distance as short as possible, I would go to where most students are scoring on the test, which is right around the mean, median, mode. So if you have 20% of all the students, you'd want to distribute that symmetrically on each side of your average. So here's me showing 10% of the students who scored in this range and 10% of the total students who scored in this range. That'd be the shortest distance where you could get 20% of all your data, and there wouldn't be much difference between these two scores. So if I know that 10% of the students are in this range right here, I also know that for this SAT score, 40% of all the students scored less than this SAT score, and on the other side, 60% scored less than this SAT score. So now we've got two things to figure out. I had to look on my Z-score chart, and I had to find the Z-score that 40% of all the data was less than that, and I got a negative 0.25. And then I need the Z-score where 60% of all the data is less than the average. Now I can look on the chart, but since a normal distribution is symmetrical, if I'm the same distance from the average, if this Z-score was negative 0.25, then correspondingly the other Z-score would be a positive 0.25. So I calculated the score for the Z-score of negative 0.25, and it was a 1425. And then I calculated the score for a positive 0.25 Z-score, and it was 1575, which again makes sense with symmetry. If I'm 75 points below the average here, then on the other one, I'm 75 points above the average. So I said the smallest range of scores that I can talk to 20% of the students who took the test is from a 1425 to a 1575.